in the aftermath of the incident of the 15th of December 2013. Personally, I am very happy to welcome and warmly receive my brother, Dr. Riek Machatei, to Juba to be with us. And I have no doubt that his return to Juba today marks the end of the war and the return of peace and stability to the people of South Sudan. The agreement on the resolution of the conflict in the Republic of South Sudan was signed in August 2015. Unfortunately, several deadlines for its implementation have been missed. And as a result, our people, as well as our international community, lost confidence in our commitment to implement the agreement in letter and spirit. Now that Dr. Riek has come and has taken oath of office as the first Vice President of the Republic of South Sudan, we will immediately proceed to establish the transitional government of national unity. This shall restore the confidence of our people and that of our international partners in our abilities as the leaders of this country to implement the agreement. Now, we must move forward in order to address the challenges occasioned by the conflict. We acknowledge that there are unresolved issues related to the agreement, but I promise we will equally resolve those matters amicably. This is the only choice for us to relieve our people from the undeserved suffering associated with the armed conflict imposed upon them. I believe this is the only way to return South Sudan to the path of peace, stability, and prosperity. In the transitional government of national unity, we do not expect opposition neither in the executive nor in the parliament. All of us who are stakeholders have the collective responsibility to make sure that we cooperate and work together as one team so that we deliver results. I therefore call upon all of you, and especially the first Vice President and the Vice President, to cooperate with me so that we return our country and people to the peaceful coexistence. The reception and the inauguration of Dr. Riek Machar as the first Vice President is the responsibility of the government of the Republic of South Sudan. Having considered all the political and security implications, the government decided that the public rally should be well prepared for the time ahead when all stakeholders, including myself, will participate in that rally. I take this opportunity to apologize to the international community for the delay in the implementation of the agreement. I also wish to express my vote of thanks to the international community, the UN Security Council, the UN Human Rights and Humanitarian Agencies, UNMISS, the Troika, AU, IGAD, EU, Russia, China, Japan, and our other regional and international partners for their positive and efforts and commitment. We appreciate their genuine concerns about the situation in South Sudan and the assistance provided to our people. Now, we are determined to see into it that we comply with our obligations as provided for in agreement and our constitution. This will enable us to meet the expectations of our people and the international community. In conclusion, Your Excellencies, I repeat our apologies.